Now at 5, it seemed like this year we had more shark sightings than ever before off the Cape. Shark after shark after shark clearing the beaches and scaring people away. There were no shark attacks this summer, fortunately, but the number of shark sightings is going up.
A new study finds there's no easy way to stop shark attacks, but the key is awareness. Here's WBZ's Bill Shields on Cape Cod.
It is an inspiring place of raw beauty. But in recent years, great white sharks have made the Outer Cape their summer home.
We essentially have now an intact marine ecosystem with an apex predator present.
In the summer of 2018, two people were attacked by great whites on the Cape. One attack was fatal. Since then, satellite phones have been installed at many beaches and equipment to stop bleeding from traumatic wounds. But some beachgoers want more protective measures, like shark barriers in the water.
Any kind of barrier technology where it has been successful in other areas has been for small coves that typically have hardened shoreline that they can anchor to. We just simply do not have that on the Outer Cape.
A consortium of towns have formed a group to study the issue. Now their report says the bottom line is educating the public.
How do we tell people to avoid an attack? And how do we as a community respond? So we've done that as far as increasing the Stop the Bleed kits.
The sharks come here to feed on the growing seal population. So for now, the emphasis will be on educating beachgoers.
There is no one solution that's going to allow for people to be safe should they choose to enter the water.
So as long as the seal population is as big as it is, the sharks will likely continue to come here. Bottom line is it will be up to people to change their habits. In East Ham, I'm Bill Shields, WBZ News.